Darul, Uloom, Pretoria, Darul, Uloom, Pretoria, Darul, Uloom, Pretoria.
Allahi Rabbil Alameen. ولا عاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ومن يطيع الله ومن يطع الله والرسول فأولئك مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد وبارك وسلم وصلي عليه Respected teachers, fellow colleagues, brother in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention in the Holy Quran. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنَعَمَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنَعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا. And he who obeys Allah and his Prophet, then he will get the company those who have been blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of the prophets and the truthful and the martyrs and the righteous, and what good company they are. Respected audience, the reason of this ayah being revealed is that one of the companion of the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, whose name was Hazrat Sauban radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he presented himself in the court of the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, and he was upset and he was looking uneasy. Because of uneasiness, the color of his face was changed. The Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam asked him the reason of his sadness. The lover of the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam replied to them that, O Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayka wa sallam, O Messenger of Allah, I do not have any physical problem, nor do I have any bodily pain. But the reason is this, that when your blessed face Mubarak is hidden from my eyes, so I become keen to do the ziyarat of your blessed face Mubarak. So immediately I presented myself in the court of the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, and I feel relaxed. And I feel relaxed and my heart get peace and satisfaction by looking at your face Mubarak. But the thing which disturbed me, that when we will leave this world, And Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will be in the highest level of Jannah, and this servant of yours will be laying in one corner, and I will be deprived from looking at your face, Mubarak. And if I don't get to see your blessed face, Mubarak, then all the bounties of Jannah, all the favors of Jannah will mean nothing to me. And I won't be able to bear your distance. By hearing this emotional talk from his companion, the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam replied to them. He said, "Oh my companion, al-mar'u ma'a man ahabba yawm al-qiyamah. A person will be with his beloved on the day of judgment. At the same moment, Sayyiduna Jibreel alayhi salatu was salam came to Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam with glad tidings that وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ. And this is the situation is not only for Hazrat Sauban radiallahu ta'ala anhu, but in fact, this situation is all the lovers of Allah, Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. The audience, the demands of love, that whomsoever you love, you must remember him in abundance. As the beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Man ahabba shay'an fa'akthara zikrahu." Whoever loves something, he will remember it in abundance. So whoever remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in abundance, surely he will also love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What do I mean by this? That even though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is free from all these desires, how would he express the desire of love? It is clarified by the narration of Hazrat Aisha Sadiqa radiallahu ta'ala anha, whereby she said that "Man ahabba Allah ta'ala fa'akthara zikrahu." Whoever loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will surely increase his remembrance. So the result of this is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant his mercy and he forgive him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will enter him in Jannah with his prophets, with his pious servants. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant him status by giving him opportunity of doing his ziyarat. The one who loves the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, surely he will increase the durood o salam upon the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Due to that, he will get the intercession of the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, and he will get the company of the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam in Jannah. Now the question is, what is love? What is the definition of love? What is the recognition of love? The recognition of love, that whosoever you love, you must follow him and remember him in abundance. Hazrat Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrates by the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala wasallam that the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala wasallam said, "Man ahabba sunnati faqad ahabbani." ila akhir. Whoever loves my sunnah, in fact he will loves me. And whoever loves me, he will be with me in the Jannah. Further, Hazrat Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu mentioned that whoever wants to make the ziyarat of the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, he should love the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. To show his love, he should act upon the sunnah of the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Because the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, whoever loves something, he will remember it in abundance. Whoever follows the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam in the light of Sharia and act upon his sunnah, he will achieve great reward of his action. In the conclusion of my lecture, that love of Allah and love of His Rasul becomes reason to get the company of Awliya Allah and Allah's righteous servant. As Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu mentioned from the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, a person came to the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam and he asked him, O Prophet of Allah, O Messenger of Allah, inform me about that person who loves a nation. Will he be included in that nation? The Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam replied to him that Al-mar'u ma'a man ahabba yawm al-qiyamah. The person will be with his beloved on the day of judgment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us his love and his love of his prophet, love of his rasul. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the company of awliya Allah and the Allah's righteous servant. وَمَا تَوْفِيقِ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْذُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ لَعَنَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. Those people who try to harm Allah and His Rasul, Allah cursed them in this world and hereafter as well, and for them is a painful punishment. Those people who trouble Allah and trouble Rasulullah, there is a painful azab for them here in after. And in the Hadith Pak, Afdalul Jihadi Kalimatul Haq in the Sultan in Jair in Awkamakal alayhi salatu salam. The best jihad is to say the word of truth in front of a tyrant king. A ruler who is a tyrant, a ruler who is not obeying the rules of Islam, he doesn't consider Islam a supreme religion. In front of him to say the words of truth is the best of jihad. That is the excellent jihad. So this type of jihad takes place from time to time. Anywhere a tyrant appears, any person appears in the form of a man, but actions are actions of carnivorous animals. So over there a lion also appears, over there a mujahid also appears. It happens in the north or in the south or in the east or in the west, anywhere in the world. It happens time to time. So from here, we must understand that respect of the Prophet, not only our Prophet, respect of all the Prophets is the foundation of faith of every Muslim. Respect of the Prophet is foundation of the faith and of the belief of every Muslim. So nobody should play with any Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody is allowed to declare the revelation, to declare the law of the Prophet. Nobody can declare the prophetic law an evil law. The law of the Prophet, law of Quran, can't be considered as evil law, can't be considered as the harmful law for the mankind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declares a law, a beneficial and life-giving, and mankind in the world, they declare it as an evil law. So you can see that Allah is supreme or that person is supreme. So definitely that person is on the mistake and that person is wrong, and law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prevails. So a law of security of the honor of the Prophet is the law of Quran, is the law of Hadith, law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So any person who declares this law as the black law or dark law, evil law, it means he is declaring the Holy Quran a dark book, a black book, or backward book. Islam means, according to that, Islam in Islam is the religion of backward people. Islam doesn't have full code of life. So all these are accusations on Islam, on Quran, on the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So nobody should think like that. Before thinking, before declaring any Islamic law, you have to think hundreds of times that are you right or wrong. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the guidance on the right path. May Allah keep firm on the straight path of Islam. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillah.